Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Please welcome our next speaker, Mr. Abhay Kapoor, HR Lead, Amazon.
I would like to call upon Dr. Rashmi Mahajan, Deputy Director, BITM, to welcome Mr. Abhay Kapoor with a bouquet.
Thank you, ma'am. May we now call upon Mr. Rahul Mundra, Student Manager, Balaji Institute of Telecom and Management, to introduce Mr. Abhay Kapoor.
Thank you, Simantika, ma'am. A very good evening to one and all present. It is my proud privilege to introduce our guest speaker for this session, Mr. Abhay Kapoor. Abhay Kapoor, sir, has over 24 years of HR experience in MNCs and Indian organizations across e-commerce, pharmaceuticals, chemicals, consumer durables, engineering, IT and ITS, FMCG, and manufacturing sector. Abhay Kapoor, sir's area of expertise include devising and implementing HR strategies, partnering with business, optimizing manpower productivity, succession planning, senior management hiring and retention, talent management and development, compensation and reward, institutionalizing, employee engagement, work-life balance and fun at the rate work, Oracle HR, SAP HR, EPMS, e-learning, online LMS. He is currently HR leader, Indian Operations North at Amazon. Before Amazon, Abhay sir has worked with Escorts Limited, Sun Pharma, LG Electronics, Tube Investment of India, etc. Abhay Kapoor sir is an alumni of Jivaji University, from where he has done BSc, MBA and LLB. Sir, now I request you to please enlighten us with your words of wisdom. The dice is all yours, sir.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everybody. So first of all, I'm thankful to Professor Baluri and all the students of Balaji for giving me an opportunity to come here and share my knowledge, whatever I have learned in last 2 decades in corporate sector. As the theme was very general, to prepare you guys for the corporate career, but as I come from a hardcore HR background and what journey I have traveled in last 2 decades in terms of being an HR professional and supporting business, and the kind of challenges and kind of issues the HR professionals face in working in the organization and creating their own identity to add value in the business and organization. So that is something I thought that maybe right from the early stage, if you can understand those kind of challenges. I don't know how many of you are going to work in HR. Can I see the hands? How many of you? Okay, so quite large number. So at least I see that there is some takers who will take me very seriously. But I'll request others also to take it very seriously, as HR is a function, whether you work in a marketing or operations or whatever function you work. People management is something which will be required as you grow in the organization. As you start managing your teams, as you start managing organization, as you grow in the ladder, the number of people, the team size will increase, and the people management as a skill is something which you will need on your day-to-day operations. So how we can transform a HR professional into a business leader, or what business expects from a HR professional. That is something which we all are struggling, still struggling, I'll say. As I come very much inside from the business, I see that all HR professionals, whatever we see outside the market, but they all are struggling in the organization to create their own identity and to add value to the business and earn trust from the business leaders in terms of their value addition. So does the business accept HR for what? Primarily, we have seen that HR has been seen as a what? Support function. So what they will do? They will hire people and they will create certain processes where deliveries are ensured, and when those people are not required or when those people are retiring, they have to ensure that they are going happy from the organization. But is it only job which HR should be doing? No. So HR people, since they come with a lot of people management skills, the organization really want to use them into so many aspects. As an internal consultant for lot many things, whereas what kind of cross team alignment, what kind of cross projects team alignments. This is something where HR has to play a major role in terms of creating a right structures in the organization. So when we look at certain organization, if I talk about very traditional organizations which are there for a few decades, and then we see them as compared to the multinational organizations, what is the big difference we find in terms of structures? All traditional organizations have a lot of hierarchical driven structures, wherein and a lot of MNCs we find that they are very flat in structure, they don't have much hierarchy, and then they work as a team. There's no junior senior relationship, wherein couple of organizations are junior. So how a right kind of structure should be there in an organization, here HR plays a very vital role. Then creating a culture of motivation, where people feel highly engaged with the organization, they work for the organization, they say positive about the organization, they strive for the organization, they stay with the organization for the longer time. So that is a big business support which every business leader always looking at the HR person, that how can I minimize the attrition in my team? I don't want people, capable people, to leave my team. How to leverage that process of ensuring that attrition is not there or attrition is very less? That is something where an engaging and motivational environment needs to be created in the organization. And how we are integrating different businesses. So HR is also required to ensure that businesses are not operating in silos. There should not be the culture of marketing versus finance, or finance versus supply chain, or something like that. So that is something like how to integrate the mechanism within the organization, how to create different processes of ensuring that all the functions are working in one direction. There is a lot of synergy and synchronization, and the top leadership, the CEOs, are not looking at, and CEOs expect HR to drive that function in the organization. So these are something which always business is looking at, that yes, not only from hiring and firing, we need HR to really be integral part of the organization, understand business and drive the business and drive the people, drive the leadership. So what they expect from HR people to know, that they should be knowing that what are the business nitty-gritties of the business, industry trends, where the industry is heading towards, how the company makes money. Sometimes HR people are so engaged with the people and people practices that there's not much focus on the business. And ultimately, if you are not knowing that from where the business is coming, from where the customer are coming, how we are going to deal with the customer, how business is dealing with the customer, and how organization is making money, HR itself becomes in the silos. Then what drives the long-term competitive advantage? What are the skills? So HR need to be the futuristic. So understanding the industry trends, understanding the competition, understanding the global environment, and becoming the future ready in terms of skills. So to forecast what kind of skills would be required in coming next couple of years and how we are going to be ready for that, what preparations are required. So supporting business or informing business in that and taking business on board on all these activities much before ahead of the time. So that is something which HR plays a very critical role in supporting business. What are the new competitions are coming? What are the new products are coming in my business? How can I drive innovation in the organization to beat the competition? So these are a couple of things where HR need to be seen as a leader in driving innovation in the organization through people. So now service is also becoming a very important part. And how the world-class service standards need to be adopted in the organization, self-service and data management. Data management and data analytics is one area where business expectation is very high from the HR professionals, and they expect that people, HR people should be able to link the people data with the business data. So what volume of business we are going to get, what volume of problems we are going to get in the business, and how kind of a people management we are going to drive, the people support we are going to provide in terms of manpower planning, in terms of ensuring the mobility of the people, in terms of ensuring the diversity of the people, in terms of ensuring the right kind of skill sets and ensuring the less attrition. So these are something like which are highly data driven, and the business expects a lot of data around these things to ensure that yes, their business is going to not going to suffer because of any kind of fallbacks in HR and people management. Apart from business, we also need to understand that what are the SLAs on which business is operating, how difficult it is to get a business, like they should have an empathy to the end customer, to the end person who is going into the market, the sales representative, or the person who is doing the manufacturing, what kind of service levels we are expected from there. And HR should align to that kind of service level. A kind of customer customer focus is required. So every time HR is operating, they should not be operating only keeping the employees in the mind, they should be operating in terms of keeping the end customer in the mind. So I'll just give you one example of my previous organization here. So we also understood this when I was working with Escorts Limited, where tractor was a very, very key product, major product for our business. And we realized that in the environment in which we work, we manufacture, this is mostly an urban area where we hire people from the campuses and ITIs and all, and they are quite diploma engineers and all, and they are quite educated people. They actually don't understand that what a farmer is looking in a tractor. So we as a HR, we started initiative, and we created a program which we called that as a customer empathy program, and wherein we created a lot of teams in the organization. Month on month basis, we started sending them to the villages, where they will go for 1 week. They will live with the village farmers. They will do farming with them. They will go to their farms. They will stay with them in their small houses. They will do all dung cleaning and taking care of the buffaloes and all. And that really helped a lot in creating a right kind of customer obsession in the mind of the employees, that who is my end customer? What is his need? How he lives? What he expects from a tractor. So that kind of a model which business expects. And this model, when we created in HR, and then we run it for almost 2 years, and when about 800 employees have gone through this program, so it get a very high appreciation from the business. Yes, HR is not only talking about managing people, but they are also obsessed about reaching to the end customer and understanding and aligning the customer with the business. So today, whether we are operating in India or we are operating outside India, we are a large or we are a small, our competition is always global. So how to create the global competitiveness in the mind of the people and ensure that capabilities are built around organization in the people with the global competitiveness in the mind. So that is one of the key thing which business always expects from the HR leaders today, whether they are working in a small size or big size or Indian or multinational, that they should be able to align people and create an environment in the organization in terms of creating the global competitiveness in the organization. They should have sufficient knowledge of the talent markets. They should have sufficient knowledge of accessing talent in the global geographies. Then use of technology. That is one more thing. How technologically advanced HR processes we can develop in the organization. Today, CEO don't want to approach a HR person to get any kind of report. He just want a platform that he can log into that platform and he should be able to access entire knowledge from there and should be able to analyze data, process data and make the business decisions out of those data. Gone are the days when HR people will provide lot of MIS and prepare lot of data and then go and present to the business leaders. So how technologically advanced we are in ensuring that the different kind of dashboards which are required from different businesses, different CFOs and departmental heads, we are able to prepare that. So it is a lot of internal customer satisfaction point of view. Then how are we able to make the organization future ready in terms of building the leadership pipeline? So today the biggest challenges which we are facing in the organization is leadership pipeline is not ready. So having a right kind of succession plan for each critical role in the organization and preparing a series of successors for that, investing a lot of time in developing those successors, having a proper leadership development programs for those successors, and giving a confidence to the business that even if tomorrow our business is growing multifold, we have a lot of internal resources available in the organization. We are investing a lot on the internal resources to ensure that yes, there will be no crisis in the business, there will be no crisis in terms of managing business from the people perspective. So last couple of years, more precisely last one decade, we have seen that how data is becoming very important in taking the business decision and how data and people and processes, all three have to be integrated to each other to give the best business results in the organization. So HR, technology and business, from the data perspective, from process perspective and from people perspective, have to align with each other, create an efficient ERP system in the organization, create opportunity and then effectiveness of all data analysis to give the best of the best business, to meet the best of the business objectives. So as I talked about the global competitiveness, so having knowledge about the different demographics, labor market, having the ability to company to hire, retain and engage people, and then understanding the high performing leaders available in the industry and comparing your people with the highest level caliber people available in the industry. Sometime when we want to hire the best of the best people from the industry, all the time we could not succeed. okay, because every organization want to retain their high caliber people. So business expects HR from that we should be able to create those kind of high caliber people by benchmarking other organizations, and we should create our own internal leadership development programs and skill development programs to ensure that we are internally creating high caliber people. Every time we should not say that, okay, we need this caliber of people, these people are available in outside market and we can hire them on such and such premium. That premium is something which is making the entire salary structure in the organization very heavy. So business expects cost optimization in terms of people also. So how to ensure that in the limited cost within the profit, within the given cost structure, you are able to provide that kind of competency and capability within the organization. So for any HR person, it is very easy route to hire people by paying higher salaries from the outside. But that is not the expectation of the business. So HR need to invest a lot in developing internal talent and benchmark with them the highest caliber people available in the industry. So in HR goals, in the matrices on which HR is being evaluated, there's a lot of focus on client satisfaction and customer feedback. So how can we link the customer feedback or the customer satisfaction level with the HR processes? That is also something which is business is always expecting. Few days back, I was just reading one article wherein they said that the recall of 8 lakh vehicles of Toyota was only because HR failed in their responsibilities. So when I started reading, I found it very interesting. So normally in this kind of business failures, quality or technical or production team will be held responsible, not the HR. But that article was very interesting. They somehow driven down that how HR failed in attracting the right kind of talent, how HR failed in giving the right kind of training, how HR failed in ensuring the quality standards in the hiring process, how HR failed in not retaining the right talent at the right time or not able to provide the right kind of structure. So that article also gave me a lot of insights that yes, HR is actually responsible for lot many things which may ultimately end up in some kind of crisis for the business. So how you are aligned with the you are able to foresee any kind of fallouts which may not be directly linked with HR, but at the root cause HR could be responsible. So how we feel talent matrix in terms of having business outcomes, not only limited to the retention and hiring numbers. How we treat people. People are cost or people are profit? And who is responsible to ensure that people are profit? Why only HR? It is ultimately the team leader and HR both have to work together to ensure that people always remains as a profit, people are asset in the organization. People are not seen as a cost, people are not seen as a liability, people are always seen as a capital. So it reminds me of another the incident when I was listening to Mr. K.V. Kamath who was the chairman of ICICI Bank. So he also stated in one of his address that for him capital is not money. For him, the way he has grown the ICICI Bank, the capital was people and technology. So how people can think at the rate of thoughts, how people can act at the rate of thoughts, enabling that kind of technology is real capital for any business. So another area where business expects HR people to lead is change management. Now that change management is happening in terms of changing the product portfolios or in terms of changing the business locations, in terms of changing the leadership, in terms of changing the structures, in terms of changing the technology. That one expectation is always there from HR is that they will drive the change. They will lead the change, because change management process involves a lot of complexities in terms of aligning mindset, in terms of defreezing, in terms of ensuring that it is not seen as a bottleneck by the people, and creating a comfort zone around the change, because change is a process where people are not willing to come out of the comfort zone. And it requires a lot of behavioral interventions, a lot of developmental interventions during the process of change management to ensure that change is taking place in the organization and becoming profitable for the organization. So they are involved in project planning, they are involved in implementation of the projects, they are involved in aligning people, different teams which are involved in the change management process. Every change management process requires a lot of reskilling. So HR is anyway responsible for reskilling of the people. Reinforcing the reskilling and about ensuring the leadership as the most important HR skills. So as I told you that the biggest problem which we see in developing the leadership pipeline, so leadership is something that how we can create leaders out of managers in the organization. That is a core objective which HR has to deliver. HR is responsible for how, not only for ensuring that how to lead people, but also to ensure that how to coach leaders. So every CEO has a huge expectation that who will support my leaders, who will coach my leaders, who will take them to the next level. So HR need to create certain processes to have a kind of lot of interactions, to create top leadership development programs, to create a lot of coachings, to ensure a mentoring and coaching system in the organization, which can take leaders and which can create leaders and coach leaders for the next level assignments, and how to lead their own teams. As the organizations are becoming bigger, HR structures are also becoming bigger. So you can easily imagine to manage, suppose an organization is having 1 lakh or 1,50,000 employees, what could be the size of an HR team to manage that kind of employees base? That could also be in 1,000. So how HR leader is ensuring and leading a team of such a large HR professionals, that is also very complex and critical. So that is also a competency which is for sort for leading the your own HR teams. Because if your HR team is not effective, if your HR team is not contributing in their own sphere, their own domain, you will have a lot of call outs from the business from different angles. So developing and coaching your own HR team for the finest level of delivery, that is also a very critical job of any HR leader. So as we talk about large HR teams, so sometimes it is understood that, okay, they are HR people, they don't need any HR. They know everything, they are supposed to take care of themselves. They are there to motivate other people, they are there to give coaching and feedback to other people. But what about what about the HR professionals? So now a lot of organizations are coming up with a separate HR for HR function. Okay, so the HR within the HR will ensure only the leadership, coaching, guidance and performance metrics of only HR people, so that HR people are also delivering to their next level. So this is not a scene which was seen earlier, but now it is becoming with the large HR teams that they need a focused, they are at the end of the day, they are also employees. And a strong project management or change management implementation skills. Another thing which every business expects is that I want to be the best employer. Even in lot of interviews, the CEOs or MDs ask that, how can you make my organization as the best employer? So from that perspective, a business expects that the best of the best practices are benchmarked and implemented in the organization. Every MD or every owner or CEO want that, yes, his organization should be seen as an organization which is people friendly, which attracts the talent, which is known as the best employer in the industry. So how to create that kind of a structure in terms of or processes which requires in an organization to become best employer? That is also a very fast growing business need, because when you are branded as best employer, then only you are able to attract the best talent from the market. I'll skip few slides because I want to cover more relevant slides. So how a HR professional can be seen as an internal consultant in driving and growth of the business? So there's a lot, customer focus has to be the center point. How to create ethical business system in the organization? Leading the trainings for the leaders. Transformation of the strategic plan, change management. Doing audits on values and culture. Sustainable purpose of the organization. Innovation, research and development. So these are certain key expectations of the business where HR need to continuously provide support and has been seen as a key driver and consultant for the business. So when we talk about developing leaders in the organization, when we talk about developing leadership competencies and leadership pipeline in the organization, There are three type of basic developmental programs which we require from the future leaders in terms of development. One, what is required for them to manage business? So in terms of managing business, the key important aspects are change management and innovation and strategic orientation. So these are two developmental areas which are required to be worked on top leadership team to make them, to take them to the next level of CEOs. Then second thing is that how to develop competencies in them on managing others, how to become team leader, how they can manage their own teams, how they can manage others in the organization. Not only their own teams, but sometimes you are also required to manage your peer group. And what are the competencies required for that? Basically, on the team leadership, customer orientation, and influencing others. That is very critical skill which are required to lead the team. And the third thing, as an individual contributor, as a custodian of your own role in the organization, how are you going to manage yourself and your own job? For that, the basic skills which are required, like result orientation, problem solving, and personal effectiveness. So these are a couple of things, like divided into three areas: managing business, managing team, and managing self. These are the leadership programs which minimal leadership programs which are expected out of HR to drive in the organization for developing people capabilities. So I think that is most of the theory part or most of the practical exposures which I have gone through, I have shared with you, and we can further enlighten this topic by knowing your queries or questions, and then maybe to the best of my capabilities, whatever I can answer. Thank you very much.
Now the house is open for questions.
Hello. Yeah. Good evening, sir. Sir, I'm right here. First row.
Okay.
Yeah. Good evening, sir. Sir, my question to you is, out of all the various management theories and practices, why did Amazon choose to adopt the Kaizen style of management? And how useful has its implementation been to the organization?
Am I audible? So I could not understand your question, actually. And only one request, I don't want to take any question which is specific to any organization. I'm here only for the general questions, so I'll give you only general replies, not specific to any organization.
All right. So I'll make it more general. So what do you think are the possible positive effects of the Kaizen style of management in towards any organization?
So you want to know about Kaizen or you want to know the effectiveness of Kaizen
yes,
in an organization?
Yes.
Okay. So you have basic understanding of Kaizen?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So Kaizen, as you all know, has been started from the Japanese organization, and they use this tool very effectively in basically automobile sector. But as a process, it has lot of outcomes in a positive direction, that lot of service organizations also are using Kaizen as an tool for bringing effectiveness. So it also helps you in identifying the
root cause of the problem and then work on the innovation and improvement in that particular process or the product to improve it further. So I think only since it has been proven over a period of time, it has delivered results, it is very effective tool, so that is why it is being used. So I'm still not able to understand that what you
no
want.
No problem, sir. Thank you so much.
Good evening, sir. Sir, at top. Sir, my name is Anadi Divedi and I am BITM Marketing Senior Batch. So my question is, last year you came to know that there had a case defense with Defense Army regarding with the drones that you are banned not to deliver things through drones. So there is some solution we came for that, at least throw some light. And the other question is regarding with the performance appraisal, that what parameters you should be applied in your company so as to promote on that basis.
Okay, so I'll only reply to your second question. That is on the performance management system, because I think that is more relevant to the larger public. So what exactly you want to know about performance management system? Okay. Now that differs from organization to organization. A promotion is level of the people. And PMS is used as a tool to identify that who is ready for promotion in the organization, and it is basically the kind of roles and next level roles and positions available in the organization and who is available in the organization for take up that kind of a role. And PMS as a process ensures that only the people, those who have contributed, those who have track record of continuous contribution in the organization, those who have potential to grow up to the next role, and those who are aligned with the value chain and value system of the organization, they or those who have very good level of earned trust through the 360 degree feedback mechanism, they are getting the next level roles so that their growth in the organization also is consistent and the organization is also getting benefited of the process. So I think that gives you satisfaction as led to your question, or still you have some queries? Okay, thank you.
Good evening, sir.
Sir
is running short of time. This will be the last
sir,
question.
Sir, I'm Arvind from BITM Marketing Batch. So I had a question that as an HR, which is the as an HR, which is the most challenging work, like retaining talent or hiring a new talent?
I'll say both are equally challenged. Okay, so I don't want to differentiate that retaining challenge is more challenging than hiring talent, or hiring talent is more challenging than retaining talent. Both have their own plus and minus, and then any organization looks from both the perspective. They want to create a lot of internal talent pool, as well as they want to infuse the fresh blood also from the outside, from the hiring new talents.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Sir spoke about transforming HR professionals into skilled consultants in a session which included managing service operations, some global insights, technology to support, and the labor market and workfare to support. He also said about the change management skills and upgrading the current skills and also behavior competencies. So we look forward to many more interactions on and off the campus.
Thank you, sir. May I now request Dr. KK Valerie, Director BITM, to present a memento to Mr. Abhay Kapoor.
Thank you.